Hello everyone, White Mage Serenia here, along with a few of my friends, actually. Your cue, guys.
Kira, Jerk, and Tamer.
And Odin the Vault.
Alrighty then, this is actually a bit of
Odin the Vault.
Yep. This is actually a bit of a test recording, because I've been messing around with a program called Total Recorder, which is supposed to be a sort of virtual sound mixer. Since I don't have stereo mix and my sound card can't really support it, this program allows me to basically emulate stereo mix. So, like I said, I've been playing around with it and to see if I could get it to be able to record multiple audio streams as well as game audio. Well, I mean, yeah, and apparently I finally figured that out, so I can, like, so I'm testing it right now to see how it's going to work along with Skype, because it's going to take some, like, mixing and stuff. But anyway, long story short is I'm just mainly testing to see if it's going to, you know, work with how I need it to. Also, too, the other point of this video is to play around with the new feature that YouTube has added in, which is an idea I got from Viktor Hark, namely transcribing audio. So we might actually say some crazy things just to see how it's going to transcribe into the closed captioning thing, because that voice recognition can get some really crazy stuff. Don't believe me? Go watch Odin of the Vault's 100 subscriber video special, and my video entitled Ugh, and then my most recent video, Mega Man X2 Bonus 3, and you can, you know, do it for the lulz. The lulz! you know, you
love, huh? Well, I've just got one thing to say toward that. I have the power.
Rangers. Okay. Well, anyways, also too, I figured I would do a little bit of an update video for you guys as well. I am still working on the problem with my Pinnacle software. I haven't been able to get it to recall my Final Fantasy X or Kingdom Hearts 2 files. They're still there. I just have to figure out how to get Pinnacle to re-recognize them and sync everything back up and whatnot. I also need to actually decide whether or not I want to go ahead and start into my next LP, which you guys should have already guessed what it might be. And I'll go ahead and say it. It's going to be Legaia 2 Dual Saga. No surprise there. So, I mean, I don't know if I really want... I've also got to get back to Wild Arms as well, so I might record a couple of episodes of that later today or tomorrow. I'm not entirely sure. But for the most part, I've been wanting to start into Legaia 2. Matter of fact, Legend of Legaia 2 Dual Saga was the entire reason I even wanted to get a Dazzle. And then when I finally did get, you know, my Dazzle, I realized, you know, I actually started into Final Fantasy X. I don't know why. And it got Kira's character in Final Fantasy XI running around me in circles for some random reason. But anyway. So I guess I'll ask what you guys want me to do. Do you guys want me to put Final Fantasy X on the back burner for right now until I can catch my file back? I mean, I still have like 10 or 13 episodes of 10 that I can post from my last recording session. And I still have like 15 other episodes of Kingdom Hearts 2 I can upload as well, so I might start uploading those again soon anyway. But as far as new recordings go, I guess I'm going to ask if you guys want me to go ahead and start into Legaia 2, or if you would be more interested in me continuing Wild Arms or something like that. So I guess I'm leaving that up to you guys. Also, if Kira and Odin, if you guys want to put an update in, go ahead. I mean, now's your chance. I'll be quiet so you can talk now.
I have nothing I really want to say. I'm hoping, definitely look forward to some SMB3. I'll be putting up that up this weekend, along with an LP I recorded with another person that I keep forgetting to post up. It's rather short.
Yes.
Not you. Somebody else, Odin.
Zits.
But yeah, that's pretty much all I've got to say. Also, look for that, and Yoshi's Island is going to be coming back in a bit too. So I've got some more recording for that.
Huh.
Yeah. Well,
looks like Audacity's actually.
Well, from.
Oh, go ahead.
well, for me, you can probably expect the end of Mega Man 2 coming this week, as well as while I'm playing around with my new PS3 capture card. And I hope I can start Metal Gear Solid 2 by Sunday. If not, well, you'll hear more news from me on my own channel then.
Oh, you got a Dazzle, Odin?
Sort of like a Dazzle, but not a Dazzle. Ah. It's internal, yeah.
Internal, what?
Yeah.
A capture card that goes into a PCI slot in his PC.
Oh, okay. I thought for some reason I thought you meant a PS3 like add-on thing.
No.
Okay. He wishes.
I got a little confused.
I wish.
Yeah, yeah, really.
Make it so much easier.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Kira, I don't know if you read the description in my Mega Man X2 bonus video thingy, but I actually uploaded that straight to YouTube from, you know, the program that you sent me. I didn't even go to YouTube.com to upload it. I just uploaded it straight from the editor.
Program I sent you?
Yeah.
Sony Vegas?
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Sure enough. I might actually start using that a bit more. It's a bit weird to get used to using, but if I can upload directly from YouTube, or I mean directly to YouTube after it's edited, then that's going to make uploading a lot easier, because that's, honest truth guys, that's the main reason I don't upload every day, because it's a real pain in the arse to edit and then upload, especially considering I have a bad connection, so it usually takes me about an hour, maybe an hour and a half to upload a video that's 50 megabytes, you know, long or whatever, and it gets like 2 and 3 hours to upload a 150 megabyte file, so it's like, ugh. It's just I don't want to deal with that every day.
Yeah.
That's why I don't always update. So I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, I can understand that, to be honest, because I actually didn't know that you could upload directly from Sony Vegas.
Yeah.
But some of my Legend of Mana videos, the more recent ones I posted, were edited with Sony Vegas, which is why the fast forwarding is a bit different. It's not chipmunked like it is in Windows Movie Maker. It's my own voice. Sped up.
Yep. That's probably how NCS does it as well. I think he uses Vegas. But as far as that, all that goes, Sony Vegas is actually a softer program, too. It doesn't take as much resource to use as Windows Movie Maker does, so it's kind of nice like that. The only problem is I haven't figured out how to do the widescreen on it yet. I want to do that because I want my videos to maintain their widescreen,
Would that be HD widescreen or just normal widescreen?
Normal widescreen, I guess. Although I might not use the widescreen or something, I'm not sure.
Yeah. Because I've actually managed to get HD widescreen. I think I can probably get normal widescreen. It's basically the resolution that you set. I can't remember the resolution for widescreen.
16:9.
You just have to play around with it for a bit.
It's 16:9.
And then... No, I mean the... As in like 720 by 480 or whatever.
Oh, well...
And then when you save the video, you, Yeah.
Isn't it like...
When you save the video, you just click,
Isn't it like 740 by 468 or something for widescreen?
No, actually. But the good thing is about the version of Sony Vegas I gave you, which I got from, Dragon Lamente... it's actually the portable version, which you don't have to really pay for, nor do you have to install it. You can actually keep that on a flash drive.
Hmm.
So
it's a free one?
Yes.
Cool.
Yes, it's a free one, Taps knows.
Huh. Oh, well, looks like we're getting closer to the 10-minute mark. We're about 8:30 right now, 8 minutes, 30 seconds.
Yeah, it turned out to be, what, an update video? Well, who cares?
Yeah, really.
We are, after all, going to be messing around with the goddamn caption thing, so...
Well, I just want to wrap this up by saying, those of you that do not play Final Fantasy XI, or those of you that do, but haven't been keeping up with the news, there's some big changes coming throughout this entire year, so if you haven't read up on the news, I would suggest to do so now. I would do a discussion video on that, but I'm still collecting my thoughts on the whole thing. I mean, it's huge updates, and it's a lot to take in, so we might actually do a discussion video on that at a later time. I haven't really decided. Probably not. I really wouldn't look forward to that. But, you know, just go ahead and look at the updates, and I'll give you a brief overview. They're bringing 3 new add-on scenarios. I don't remember their name, but they're dealing with the zone called Abyssia. They're also gradually raising the level cap to 99. Yes, you heard me. Level 99 in Final Fantasy XI. June is going to be the first leg of the level increase update, which will bring it to level 80, I do believe. And they're also merging several servers, like Pandemonium will be merging with Ashura, which kind of sucks, but hey, you know, it's one of those things you just got to deal with, I suppose. It might be, you know, for the better. Among other things like that, yeah, just go ahead and check into the news if you're a Final Fantasy XI player and just see what's coming for you over the course of this next year. And, well, guys, we're at 10 minutes, so I guess we'll just wrap this up. Hopefully we'll see you all in Vanadil or on YouTube, wherever. Till then, guys, this has been White Mage Serenia.
Care Dragon Tamer.
And
Out of the Vault.
And before we sign out, one thing to say.
Quickly.
Super Bum Fucking Chaka!
Okay.
Uma, uma, uma.
How about a turkey biscuit to go along with it? Bowling, bowling, bowling. Keep those balls up, bowling.
Yeah, that was a small shout-out to Gavrock, by the way.
Ah, nice. Anywho.
Yes.
Yep. 10:30 seconds, guys, so we'll talk to you all later, and hopefully this sound quality on this video, among other things, will be pretty good. So until then, everyone, have a nice day. And also, keep off the streets. No, I'm just kidding. Have a nice day, everyone. Ice cream sundae!
Oh.